hello, how are ya? Who should I walk home with? I would still walk home with Sayori. Sayori, you really think I would ditch you for Yuri? Yuri, of all people? Come on. Eh? But she's so beautiful and smart. Jeez. I already see her in the club every day. Besides, you always seem to really like going home together. I wouldn't just ruin that for you. You're so silly, no dandy. You think about me too much sometimes. Yuri would deserve it if she wanted it, so... Sorry, I've already made up my mind. I really can't figure you out sometimes. Sorry. Besides, what's that point in speculating something that's never going to happen? The conversation trails off. It's kind of a weird thing for Sayori to care so much about. But I want to respect her and keep her happy, too. Then again, the festival's only a few days away. Who knows what will happen in that time? Uh-oh! Here we go. Sugar! Spice! Everything nice, marriage? Does she want to marry me? Sunny! Yay! Puppy! Yay! Anger! Wow! You're a little angry. Heaven sent. Lust! Oh my goodness gracious! Forgive! Yay! Heart! Yay! Perfect! Yay! After image. Tragedy. What? What? Doki doki! Anxiety. Okay. Shiny! Childhood. Embrace. Yay! Cage. I am in a cage. Unstable. Oh yeah. Okay, here we go. Pink. Aw, man. I'm the last one here again. Don't worry, I just walked in too. Were you practicing piano again? Yeah. You must have a lot of determination. Starting this club, now picking up piano? Well, maybe not determination, but I guess passion. Remember that the club wouldn't be here if it wasn't for all of you. And I'm super happy that you're all willing to help out for the festival, too. I can't wait for the festival! It's gonna be great! Eh? Weren't you complaining about it just yesterday, Natsuki? Well, yeah. I'm not talking about our part of the festival. But it's a whole day of school where you get to play and eat all kinds of delicious food.
You sound a bit like Sayori all of a sudden.
Monica, do they usually have fried squid?
Squid? That's a pretty specific thing to look forward to.
Oh, come on! Are you saying you don't like squid? You, of all people?
Are you calling her a squid?
Eh? I didn't say I don't like it. Besides, what do you mean by you, of all people? Because it's right in your name. Monica. Eh? That's not how you say my name at all. Also, that joke makes no sense in translation. Huh? Never mind. Let's just focus on our own event for now, okay? Fine. Your reactions aren't as fun as yours or Sayori's anyway.
Excuse me. Where is Sayori anyway? Oh, there you are. Sorry, you're sitting at a desk in the corner of the room, looking down at nothing. Walk over to her. Hey, Sayori. I wave my hand in front of her face.
Eh?
You're spacing out again.
Sorry. Don't mind me. You can go talk to everyone else.
Huh. Is everything all right?
Of course. Why wouldn't it be?
Just feels like you're a little off. Sorry for assuming things.
Jeez, you worry too much about me. I'm fine, see? I'm all happy again!
Sayori shows me a big smile.
Don't let me distract you from having fun with everyone.
Well, alright. If you say so. I ward the glance at Sayori before turning back towards everyone else. But the conversation has already dispersed, with everyone back at their usual activities. Maybe I should ask Monica if she's noticed anything about Sayori recently. Since they've been preparing for the festival, they must be spending a lot of time together. I timidly approach Monica, who is shuffling through some papers at her desk.
Dandy, what's up?
Hey, this might sound a little strange, but have you noticed anything up with Sayuri recently? Anything up with her? In what way do you mean? Maybe I'm reading into it a little too much, but she seems a bit downcast today.
Oh, you think so? I can't say I've noticed anything about her.
Monica peers across the room at Sayuri, who is idly dragging a rubber eraser up and down her desk.
Maybe there is something on her mind. But I'm surprised I'm not the one asking you, Nardandy. You certainly know her a lot better than I do.
Yeah, but she's never really like this. She's always talked to me about things that bothered her. But this time, when I asked her, she was really dismissive.
Sorry, I know it's not your problem.
I just wanted to ask if you knew anything, so I'll drop it now.
No. It's important to me, too. I mean, I'm also friends with her. And I also care about the well-being of my clan members, you know? Maybe I'll try talking to her myself.
Are you sure about that? She seemed like she wanted me left alone.
Are you sure?
Maybe she just has a hard time ending it up with the person of interest.
Oh, whoops. Wrong person saying it. Person of interest? What do you mean by that?
I'm saying that maybe the thing on her mind is you, Nardandy.
Me? How on earth would you come to that conclusion?
Well, I probably shouldn't say too much, but Sayuri talks about you more than anything else, you know? She's been so much happier ever since you joined the club. It's like an extra light was turned on inside of her.
What? No way. Sayuri is always like that. She's always been full of sunshine and puppies and kittens and rainbows and shit. It's not any different now than it has always been.
You're so funny, Nardandy. Have you thought that maybe you've always seen her so cheerful? Because that's just how she is when she's around you? I said too much. I'm sorry. What do I know, anyway? I didn't mean to jump to conclusions, so you should just forget about what I said. I'll try to talk to her, so try not to think about it for now.
Alright.
Monica smiles meaningfully. I know she said to forget about it, but I already know that I won't be able to get her words out of my head. Monica stands up from her desk and walks across the room to where Sayuri is sitting. I watch her kneel down next to Sayuri and gently talk to her. But she's keeping her voice so quiet that I can't hear her from her. Hear her from here. I sigh and sit myself down. I know Sayuri told me not to worry about her and to have fun with everyone else. But that's impossible to do when she's behaving like this. Exactly how much do I care about her that I'm letting this weigh me down so much? Now it feels like I'm the one behaving out of the ordinary. But there's nothing I can do besides wait for Monica.
Okay, everyone!
After some time passes, Monica calls out to the clubroom.
Why don't we share our poems now?
Before I know it, everyone's back to normal. Everyone goes to retrieve their poems, and I do the same. I make eye contact with Monica, and she smiles at me. I wonder what she was talking about with Sayuri. Who should I show my poem to first? Monica!
Hi, Nardandy. Have you thought about what you want to submit to perform at the festival?
Well, being in this club is one thing, but performing in front of a bunch of people, I'll have to give it some more thought.
Okay, no pressure. But whatever you do, I'm sure it'll turn out great.
It would also make me happy to see.
Anyway, let's take a look at today's poem.
Sure. I let Monica take the poem I'm holding in my hands.
It's kind of funny.
How so?
No, not the poem.
I mean, it's funny how your poems and Sayuri's poems have been getting more and more similar to each other every day. I'm surprised you're so in sync with her.
Then again, you've been spending a lot of time together lately, haven't you?
I guess you could say that. Although we kind of grew up as best friends, I haven't been seeing as much of her this past year. And since I joined the club, we've been spending a lot of time together again.
I see. That reminds me. About how Sawyer's been a little bit off today?
Yeah, did she tell you something?
Well, Nardandy, you haven't been flirting with you, have you?
Of course not. I've been treating her like I always do.
All right. Just making sure. I know how much you care about her. It would be terrible if something bad happened to her, so keep an eye on her.
Sayuri's been acting so much happier ever since you joined the club.
What could have happened all of a sudden? Well, never mind. This really isn't the time to be talking about this. Anyway, I'll share my poem with you now, all right?
All right. The lady who knows everything
An old tale tells of a lady who wanders earth, a lady who knows everything, a beautiful lady who has found every answer, all meaning, all purpose, and all that was ever sought. And here I am, a feather, lost adrift the sky, victim of the currents of the wind. Day after day I search. I search with little hope, knowing legends don't exist. But when all else has failed me, when all others have turned away, the legend is all that remains, the last dim star glimmering in the twilit sky. Until one day the wind ceases to blow, I fall, and I fall and fall and fall even more, gentle as a feather, a dry quill, expressionless. But a hand clutches me between the thumb and forefinger, the hand of a beautiful lady. I look at her eyes and find no end to her gaze. The lady who knows everything knows what I'm thinking. Before I can speak, she responds in a hollow voice. I have found every answer, all of which amount to nothing. There is no meaning. There is no purpose. And we seek only the impossible. I am not your legend. Your legend does not exist. And with a breath, she blows me back afloat, and I pick up a gust of wind. Oh.
Okay. You know, I feel like learning and looking for answers are the sorts of things that give life meaning. Not to get too philosophical or anything, but it was kind of on my mind, so that's what I wrote about.
I see. I never really put much thought into it.
In a way, it's almost paradoxical. Because if we had all the answers, wouldn't the world start to lose its meaning?
You know, there's one thing I noticed. It seems like everyone in the club prefers writing about things that are more sad than happy.
Mm-hmm. Are you surprised? I mean, if everything was okay, we wouldn't really have anything to write about, would we?
Humans aren't two-dimensional creatures.
I think you know better that than anyone.
You mean one-dimensional?
Yeah, that! Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Are you ever too shy to share your writing because you're afraid it's not that good? It can be really disheartening to get a lukewarm response to something you put so much into. But if you find other people who enjoy writing, then sharing becomes a lot easier. Because instead of just telling you that your writing is good or okay or bad, they'll want to focus more on everything that went into it and the things you can work on. It's much more encouraging that way, and it'll make you want to continue improving. It's almost like having your own little literature club, you know, don't you think? That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening.
Alright, Sayori, what's up with you?
This is your best one so far. It's really, really nice, Nerdandy.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, you've been a little quiet today. Is everything alright?
Of course! Everything is fine. Maybe I'm just a little tired today.
Do you want a nap or something?
No, that's silly. Don't worry about me, okay? I only want to see smiles on your face.
Well, alright.
Hey, Nerdandy? I'm still a little surprised. I really thought that you would try writing your poems like the way Yuri does. Or even Natsuki. But in the end...
Yeah, I guess you're the one who likes this one the most.
Why?
Oh, sudden silence.
You don't want to get closer with everyone else?
Wait, of course I do. But that doesn't mean I need to try so hard to impress them. I still understand you the most, Sayori. I know you have to sometimes put up with me, and I have to sometimes put up with you, but we have a wavelength or something, and this is how the poem came out. Sometimes it feels like you're the only exciting thing in my life, so sometimes it's just easier to write when thinking about you. Sorry.
No. Oh, you're crying. You're dandy. I don't deserve this. You're too nice to me. Why are you doing this?
Sari has trouble keeping her voice steady all of a sudden.
If you had fun with everyone else instead, this would be so much easier.
Sari! I glance around the room to make sure nobody has noticed this. Sari, I've probably never said this before, but I don't understand what you're feeling right now. Tell me what will cheer you up. Sari shakes her head. She sniffles and keeps shaking her head. Finally, she gathers herself and puts on a smile.
It's nothing, Nerdandy. It's just a little rain cloud. I'm sorry you had to see that. I promise it won't happen again. Just smiles from everyone, okay? That's all that matters. Go play with everyone else. I'm going to go home a little bit early today. Sayori, tell Monica I wasn't feeling well, okay? I'll see you tomorrow.
Before I can say anything else, Sayori cheerfully walks out of the classroom, humming to herself.
Oh, well, can I just go after her? Do I have to share? Okay, whatever.
This one's all right.
All right?
Well, yeah. About as good as yesterday's, anyway. I see what you're going for, but it's not really my style. I mean, that's fine. I was mostly just glad that you're trying a little bit.
Well, of course I'm at least trying.
Why are you so emotionally invested in my poems, anyway?
Oh, that was me. That was me. Ah! Isn't that more of a compliment to me?
Eh? No, gross. It's not like I care or anything. It's just that one of us in this club has to make sure you're not slacking off.
Really? Well, what if you ended up just scaring me away?
That's... It's not like you would actually do that.
Yeah, you're right. It's kind of fun to hang out here, even if I have to put up with you.
Ugh.
Oh, that was me! Again! Ugh, I'm horrible at this. Tatsuki's elbow connects with my stomach.
Oh, maybe I won't mind scaring you away after all.
I was just joking.
Oh, I know. Don't worry. I was too.
Dying. How the hell do you call that a joke? That seriously hurt. Well, maybe it was funny to her. I guess that's kind of the point. I should really just wash my mouth around Tatsuki.
Anyway,
Natsuki holds her poem out to me like nothing even happened. I'll be your beach. Your mind is so full of troubles and fears that diminish your wonder over the years. But today I have a special place, a beach for us to go. A shore reaching beyond your sight, a sea that sparkles with brilliant light. The walls in your mind will melt away before the sunny glow. I'll be the beach that washes your worries away. I'll be the beach that you daydream about each day. I'll be the beach that makes your heart leap in a way you thought had left you long ago. Let's bury your thoughts, your heavy thoughts, in a pile of sand. Bathe in sunbeams and hold my hand. Wash your insecurities in the salty sea and let me see you shine. Let's leave your memories in a footprint trail. Set you free in my windy sail. And remember the reasons you're wonderful when you press your lips to mine. It'll be the beach that washes your worries away. I'll be the beach that you daydream about each day. I'll be the beach that makes your heart leap in a way you thought had left you long ago. But if you let me be by your side, your own beach, your own escape, you'll learn to love yourself again.
Yeah! I felt like I kept writing about negative things, so I wanted to write something with a nice message for once. Besides, the beach is awesome! Kinda hard to write anything negative about the beach.
So you decided to write about the beach first and then came up with a message later?
Yeah, well, it's only because of what happened yesterday. I mean, after Yuri and I realized we kind of wrote about the same thing. She wanted to pick a topic and have us both write about it, or whatever. Ugh, can you really see her doing that, too? Maybe get us write about a simple topic than trying to impress me by coming up with something all fancy. Well, it's not like I care. I just did it anyway. I mean, I guess mine ended up being kind of metaphorical, too. But there's nothing wrong with doing that once in a while. At the very least, it was good practice.
Oh, Yuri time!
Well, it's on there, Dandy. You've definitely improved your writing over the course of these few days. Has my advice been helpful to you?
Yeah, definitely.
I'm glad. Sharing a writing like this is a lot more fun and rewarding than I anticipated. I need to remember to thank Monica. I think we all felt a little awkward at first, but now it seems like everyone is enjoying sharing their writing and seeing what others think.
I guess I can't really disagree. I was afraid this whole thing would be a chore. Well, it's a great way for me to spend some personal time with all the girls in the club. But it's been fun getting to know everyone and their writing. And I guess doing some writing myself.
Well, have you learned anything about yourself, Nadandy?
Eh?
Well, you know how I like to say that writing is a very personal way to get in touch with yourself. In the end, it doesn't matter if you're a good writer or a bad writer. And even my opinions are just opinions, you know? As always, I believe what's most important is exploring and discovering yourself.
That's comforting. I'm kind of afraid of disappointing you in some way or another.
Eh? Why me?
Well, you're always sophisticated with your writing and have the most advice to share.
Is that so?
Yuri thinks for a good minute.
That must be terrible.
Eh? me to have become someone whose opinion is fearsome. How unlikable of me.
Yuri, it's not as bad as you're making it sound in your head. I just meant that I respect your opinion.
I see. I'm sorry that I always overthink and come to these sorts of conclusions. I'm just a little too used to it.
Overthinking?
Being disliked.
Yuri,
what am I saying? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to bring that up. Let's move on.
Alright. Do you want to share your poem now?
Okay. Here.
Beach. A marvel millions of years in the making, where the womb of Earth chaotically unmeets the surface, under a clear blue sky, an expanse of bliss, but beneath grey rolling clouds, an endless enigma. The easiest world to get lost in is one where everything can be found. One can only build a sandcastle where the sand is wet, but where the sand is wet, the tide comes. Will it gently lick at your foundations until you give in? Or will a sudden wave send you crashing down in the blink of an eye? Either way, the outcome is the same, yet we still build sandcastles. I stand where the foam wraps around my ankles, and my toes squish into the sand. The salty air is therapeutic. The breeze is gentle yet powerful. I sink my toes into the ultimate boundary line, tempted by the foamy tendrils. Turn back, and I abandon my peace to a road at the shore. Drift forward, and I return to Earth forevermore.
I'm aware that the beach is kind of an inane thing to write about, but I did my best to take a metaphorical approach to it.
Yeah, Natsuki already told me about it.
She did? She didn't say anything weird, did she? She just wanted us to write about the same topic again. I suppose to better compare the difference in our writing styles, our thought processes. Anyway, it was her idea. Knowing her, it's no surprise that she'd want to do something like that. She probably just wants to show off. It's not like I have a particular interest in her writing style. I just went with her request. But, well, I suppose it's not so bad to write about something simple on occasion. It can be refreshing, you know? It's good for me to calm my thoughts once in a while.
Yeah, I think I agree. Thanks for sharing.
Okay, you three. We're all done sharing poems, right? Why don't we start figuring out? Hold on a second. Is it just me, or did you say something strange just now?
Huh? Something did sound a bit unusual.
That's right.
You deviated from your usual catchphrase when addressing the club.
Catchphrase? I don't have a catchphrase. Jeez. I have some mood so weird today. Look, even Yuri isn't immune to it.
Ugh. Stagnating air is common foreshadowing that something terrible is about to happen.
In your books, maybe.
Look, the only thing different is that Sayuri isn't here.
Ah, it seems you're right.
Ah. Sayuri always helps lighten the mood a little bit, doesn't she? It's almost like everyone's balance is thrown off a little when she's not around. Where the heck did she run off to, anyway? I thought she just went to pee.
Natsuki, please show some decency.
Oh, come on!
Actually, she wasn't feeling too well and went home early.
Is that so? I hope she's alright.
Seriously? Of all the times to not go home with her, you picked the time she's not feeling well?
So much for
you two being all lovey-dovey.
No. First of all, stop misunderstanding my friendship with Sayuri. And second, she's kind of been avoiding me today, too, so I don't really want to force it.
Oh?
That curious expression coming from Yuri, of all people.
Calm down, guys. I talked to her earlier, and everything is fine.
What did she say?
Anyway, we need to figure out the rest of the festival preparations, so let's decide what everyone will be doing this weekend. I already know what I'm doing. That's right. Natsuki will be making cupcakes. But we might need a lot of them in different flavors. Can you handle that all by yourself, Natsuki? Challenge accepted. And as for myself, I'm going to be printing and assembling all the poetry pamphlets. Sayuri will be helping me design them. And as for Yuri, Yuri, you can, huh? Guys, can you help me come up with something for Yuri?
I'm useless.
No, that's not it at all. You're the most talented person here, you know? Now, Natsuki's pouting too?
Jeez, even I can tell now. I guess I never gave Sayori enough credit, but I can tell things are even harder on you when she's not around.
That may be the case. But if I can't also be a leader on my own, then I won't grow as a person. So, Yuri, you have beautiful handwriting, you know? So you should make some banners and decorations to help set the atmosphere.
Atmosphere? About that. I love atmosphere.
Yuri's expression suddenly changes as she stares at her desk in focus and starts nodding to herself.
Your mind is already racing, I see. That's great! You'll be a wonderful help, Yuri. But anyway, that just leaves you, Nerd Dandy. The one who is truly useless, that's me.
Haha, don't say that. In fact, both Atsuki and Yuri have some pretty heavy tasks to handle. It would probably go a long way to give one of them a hand. You could always help me out as well. I would be really appreciative of that.
Is Monica suggesting I spend the weekend with one of my club members?
Ooh!
How on earth are they going to respond to a suggestion like that?
I suppose I wouldn't mind a bit of help.
Well, even if you don't know how to bake, there's always some dirty work I could give to you. It's not like Monica's gonna give me a choice, and you shouldn't be sitting on your butt anyway.
Asuki tries to mumble a bunch of excuses like that.
If I recall, Natsuki, you mentioned that you would like to handle the baking on your own. Your Dandy may not like to be around if you only make him out to be a nuisance. So therefore, you may be more suited to assisting with the decorations.
Hold on! I never said that! How hard could it be to make a few decorations anyway? Sounds more like you're just making excuses for your Dandy to.
What are you saying? It will be extremely meticulous work.
And baking isn't? Just what do you think?
Guys, let's settle down for a moment. In the end, I think it's up to Nerd Dandy to decide how he'd like to contribute. Besides, he hasn't really gotten the chance to spend any time with me yet, you know? So I'm sure he's interested in...
You literally just said!
I'm surprised as well. Sorry. I was just saying, though.
Jeez. Can we just settle this already?
Yeah. Nerd Dandy, you're okay with this, right? In the end, it's up to you.
Of course!
Very well. In that case,
everyone looks straight at me. Of course I'm gonna go with...
We'll find out next time! If you enjoyed this episode and want to see more, hit the subscribe button! Bell notification too! Like, comment if you feel like doing it! Hope you have a great day, and I hope to see you again next time! Thanks everyone! Bye!